Actor William Windom is best known for his Emmy Award-winning lead role in the short-lived television series My World and Welcome to It, based on the life and works of James Thurber, one of America's best-known humorists. Critics liked My World, called the program one of the most literate efforts in American television. But in 1970, after only one season on the air, Windom's sitcom was canceled, a victim of sagging Nielsen ratings. The Nielsens may control what you see or don't see on TV, but they have no control over how segments of the audience feel about certain programs. So when Emmy Award time came around that year, My World and Welcome to It was among the winners, right up there with the highly rated programs viewers would see the next season. Windom says his one-man show was a direct result of that failed series, and shortly after My World left the air, he began traveling around the country with a program of Thurber writings, similar in some ways to the highly successful shows about Mark Twain and President Harry Truman. In November, Windom brought the humor of James Thurber to the University of Georgia campus. At a press conference prior to his performance, the veteran actor talked about his role as Thurber, television today, about the world of acting, and how young people should go about breaking into that profession.
Well, I think they should start long before they get out of school. Now, I don't know how much theater there is in Athens, but there's some here at the college, and there are summer vacations that could be used up rather than lying on the beach or bicycling around Europe. They could be used up getting a job while you're a freshman, even as early as high school, working in a TV station as a gopher, sweeping up in a radio station or running errands for somebody, so that by the time you're out of college and still want to be an actor, you have had 15 jobs. You know what it's like. You've butted your head against the jerks, and you've hustled for a buck, and you know what it's worth. Now, you have met enough people during your college time to, let's say, make a trip to New York worthwhile, where you know six people to go and see right away, or same way in California. Because if they don't lay the groundwork, if they don't have some people to go and see who say, yes, oh, I remember you, you wrote me a letter 2 years ago, let's have a little visit. Unless you've got that, you're going to just stagger around wondering what hit you. There are 10, 20 people for every job.
If the chance presented itself, would you go back into a
situation? In a minute, yes. Because the people do not come to these shows that I like to do. I do two shows on James Thurber and two on a man named Ernie Pyle. I just started those last April. And I'm trying to get that going because I enjoy doing that work. And it pays as well as television if you can do that. But in order to do that, you've got to be seen on the tube every year by so many X number of people. If you can get a series, that's all the better. If you don't get a series, you better guest around about 8 or 10 or 20 shots. Because if they don't see you on the tube, they sure won't come to the theater.
What does the actor think about television today? He says there's some of it he likes, but there's some of it he doesn't like.
I think about 90% or 80% of what we see on television or what we eat in restaurants is potboiler routine. 10% is really memorable, and 10% should be swept under the rug. But about 80% of it is potboilers, and you get along with that. Whether it's people you meet, clothes you wear, TV shows you watch, books you read, whatever. There are too many first prizes. So I think television falls into that category, too. I think it slowly improves, just as an automobile slowly improved down through the years, theoretically. There are some very fine TV shows, yes. And then I think public television adds a great deal to what we have to look at. But I don't. That isn't all I watch. I like to watch the junk, too. I love to watch Hee-Haw about twice a year. That's fun, you know. Or Lawrence Welk. I mean, that cheers me up to see it. It's so bad, it's good again, you know. It's just, yeah. It keeps your perspective going, and it's funny. TV is my bread and butter. I would be biting the hand that feeds me to criticize it. But let me give you one educator's opinion of it. This is a man who retired as chancellor of the University of Chicago in 1951. That means television was about 6 years old when he wrote this. Part of his farewell address was, "The horrid prospect that television opens before us with nobody speaking and nobody reading suggests that a bleak and torpid epoch may lie ahead, which, if it lasts long enough, will gradually, according to the principles of evolution, produce a population indistinguishable from the lower forms of plant life." Astronomers at the University of Chicago have detected something that looks like moss growing on Mars. I am convinced that Mars was once inhabited by rational human beings like ourselves who had the misfortune some thousands of years ago to invent television. Robert M. Hutchins,
veteran actor William Windom on the college circuit with a one-man show on the works of American humorist James Thurber, inspired by the Emmy-winning television series My World and Welcome to It.